Hi everyone, and welcome to another video on Windows 11. As you might have heard, since a few days, Microsoft has released their 2023 update of Windows 11, better known as 23H2. As I did some earlier videos on getting Windows 11 on unsupported hardware, this one is no different and covers performing a fresh installation of Windows 11 23H2 on unsupported hardware. There are several other scenarios that might apply for you as well, so I decided to cover these in separate videos. As mentioned, this one is about performing a fresh Windows 11 installation. Other videos will be about upgrading to Windows 11 23H2 when you would already be on a previous Windows 11 version, or about upgrading from Windows 10 on unsupported hardware. For these different scenarios, I've put a card here, and you can find a link in the description to these videos as well. Now, since Microsoft released Windows 11 in October 2021, there has been some hardware limitations. These limitations include a limited list of processor support, the requirement for secure boot, and a TPM 2.0 module. In case one of these requirements on your machine is not met, you have an unsupported system, and without any workarounds, you will not be able to install Windows 11 on that machine. For this video, I'll use my trusty Dell OptiPlex 9020, which I also used for previous videos on Windows 11. It's equipped with a 4th generation Intel Core i5 CPU, which is not supported, and it doesn't meet the TPM 2.0 requirement either. So, in short, this machine is not officially compatible or qualified to run Windows 11 by Microsoft. If you would try to do a fresh installation without any workarounds, this is the message that you will see. In the next steps, we will prepare a USB drive that will work around that, and it will be usable to do a fresh install of Windows 11 23H2 on unsupported, but also on supported machines. The preparation steps which we will do will also take place on this machine, but they can be done on another PC as well. It doesn't have to be supported or even run Windows 11 for that. With the first version and also last year's 22H2 version, doing a fresh installation consisted of using the media creation tool, which is offered by Microsoft, to create a USB drive, then boot from it and disable the hardware checks by setting some values in the registry while installing. After testing that same method for 23H2, when using the media creation tool to create a drive and use it to install, you can still bypass that limitation for the hardware, but the resulting installation is only on version 22H2. From there, you can perfectly follow then the upgrade from 22H2 to 23H2 for unsupported hardware, but of course this takes extra effort, time and additional downloading. The way to not have this is to directly use the ISO from Microsoft's website instead and use that to do the fresh installation. I did try this by booting from the ISO directly in a virtual machine. Using the known registry workarounds, you do end up with 23H2 directly. But for most of us, using that ISO directly or to burn it to a DVD is not very handy, as we tend to use a bootable USB drive instead. So this time, for 23H2, the easiest method will be to use Rufus to create a bootable USB drive. This tool will allow you to use the ISO as a source, and even better, you can also immediately disable the hardware checks while creating the USB drive. Enough talking, let's get started with all of this. To begin, let me insert the USB drive in the PC. This has to be at least 8GB in size, and as I mentioned, you can create this on any other Windows machine, it doesn't have to be the one where you'll be doing the installation. In case you would have issues with your USB drive, or there might be an issue with leftover boot partition or weird flags on it, I've included some steps at the end of this video in order to clean this up. But for now, we'll assume you have a regular and working USB drive in good condition. The first step now is to download the tool that I mentioned, Rufus. I have put a link to their website in the description, but you can easily find them by typing Rufus in Google. On the website, scroll down to the download section. I decided to go for the portable edition, but the standard edition would do as well. And then once downloaded, navigate to your downloads folder and start the tool. Make sure you click yes to allow for application updates, as without this Rufus will not be able to download ISOs. Make sure your USB drive is the one listed in the device field, and change this if needed. Then, in the boot selection part, click on the drop-down and select Download, then click on Download itself in order to first download the list of available operating systems, and once that is downloaded, select Windows 11 from the list and click Continue. Select the only release that is available, click Continue again, and then do the same for the edition. As you see, this ISO has all versions included, so it can be used for a home or pro installation, depending on which activation key you have. Now select the language that you want and once again click on continue, and then x64 is the only architecture available. So select that and then click on download. Save the ISO somewhere in your downloads folder and let Rufus take care of downloading everything. Once the download completes, the boot selection will be automatically populated with the ISO file as you can see. And we can start creating the USB drive by clicking on start. Now this is where it gets interesting. In this Windows User Experience dialog, as I mentioned, we can already apply the required workarounds. The first checkmark is exactly what we are looking for to bypass the hardware checks for unsupported hardware. But the other options are pretty useful as well and can save you some work later. So I decided to also remove the requirement for a Microsoft account, automatically let the installer create my user account, disable the privacy settings and BitLocker encryption. Double check the device you selected as it has to match with your USB drive and then click OK to start the process. Now you will need to wait a bit as it takes some time for all the data to be copied to the USB drive from the ISO. Alright, the status is ready, so the USB drive creation is complete and we can use it now to do a fresh install. So insert the drive into the machine where you want to perform the fresh install and boot it up. Press the required key combination to bring up the boot menu, in my case this is F12. As you can see, this machine is configured for UEFI boot, so I need to select the USB drive under the UEFI entry and press enter. If your machine would be configured for legacy boot, the easiest is to enter the BIOS setup and change this to UEFI booting. If this is not an option, you can recreate the USB drive with Rufus, but then you have to select the MBR option instead of GPT in the partition scheme option. After I've selected this entry, it will start the Windows installer from the USB drive. From here, the installation is just like any other Windows 11 install. Select the language, regional settings and keyboard layout and press next. In the next screen, click on Install Now. Accept the license terms, click Next and choose for a custom installation. Here, as we want to do a clean installation, I will select each existing partition on my internal drive and delete it. Then I can just select the full unallocated space and click Next. This will let the installer create whatever is necessary and use the whole drive. From here it's mainly waiting, as the installer will copy all files to your internal drive, perform a reboot and complete the rest of the installation. If all goes well, you should end up with this setup dialog. Typically here, I would work around the requirement for a Microsoft account, but since we already did that while creating the USB drive, we don't need to do that anymore and you only need to go through a small amount of steps. So let's select our location, keyboard layout, and after confirming that we don't need a second keyboard layout, the installation will continue with the last steps. There we go, our fresh Windows 11 23H2 installation is done. Let's double check that by going to Settings, System, About. And indeed, we have 23H2 here just as we wanted. Let's double check now if we have the new features available as well. So let's go to Taskbar Settings, then Taskbar Behaviors, and as you can see, the option to never combine taskbar buttons and hide labels is here. And after aligning the start button to the left, this finally goes back to the way I always have liked it. When opening File Explorer, we can see that we have the new 23H2 browser-like interface as well. And to confirm once more, WinVer shows us that this is definitely Windows 11 23H2. One last thing which is a good idea to do is to install missing drivers through Windows Update. And this answers a question which you might have got right away as well. Yes, Windows updates do come in just fine on here, even though we're on unsupported hardware. That was it for the video. I still have a small additional part after this where I explain how to clean up a USB drive if needed. But first of all, thanks a lot for watching. Let me know how this worked for you in the comments, and if you have some questions as well, let me know there and I'll do my best to provide an answer. If you have liked this video, a thumbs up is always nice, and if you are into this kind of videos, feel free to subscribe to my channel, of course. Now, in this last part, I will show you how to clean up a USB drive if that would be needed. Especially if you had used the USB drive on a non-Windows operating system, it might not be properly detected on Windows or give you troubles when trying to get that ISO on there. These small steps will prevent any potential issues with leftover boot partition or weird flags on the drive. So, to do this, launch a command prompt by clicking on Start or pressing the Windows key and type in cmd followed by Enter. In the command prompt, type disk part and press Enter again. Here, give the command list disk. This will give you a list of disks in your system. In my case, the USB drive is the second entry here, disk 1. So, for the next command, I need to type select disk 1 and press Enter. Obviously, you need to adjust this number with the disk number you have there for your USB drive. Disk 1 got selected, so now we will clean up everything that's on the drive. Just in case this would not be clear already, this does destroy all data that's on the drive, so make sure you selected the right drive and that you don't have anything important left on there. Type clean here and press Enter once more. At this point, everything got removed from the USB drive. So, before we can start to use it again, we will need to recreate a partition on it first. For that, exit disk part and then launch diskmgmt.msc from the command prompt. In here, we can see the USB drive with all space as unallocated. Right-click on this and select New Simple Volume, click Next, leave it to use all the space and click Next again, leave the selected drive letter, click Next, and here we can give the drive a name or a volume label if desired. Then click Next again and finish to start creating the volume. There we go, the USB drive is ready to use again. Thanks again for watching and hope to see you back here soon.